बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। वी कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ टॉलरेंस। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टॉलरेंस स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर डिफाइनिंग द टर्म टॉलरेंस, let me explain background knowledge. Students, in our body there are two types of antigens. First one, self antigens, self antigens, and number two, non self antigens. What are self antigens? Students, self antigens are those antigens which are present in our body during fetal life, during our embryonic developmental life, and before the maturation of our immune system. Okay, I repeat my words. Self antigens are those antigens which are present in our body during fetal life or during embryonic development, or we can say that antigens present before the maturation of our immune system are called self antigens. For example students, my blood, body will read my blood as self antigens. My body parts, my kidneys, my lungs, my heart, my skin, all these are self antigens. Now, second type of antigen is non-self antigens. Non-self antigens. Students, non-self antigens are those antigens which later develop in our body. Or we can say that antigens which develop in our body after the maturation of our immune system are called non-self antigens. Students, body's immune system never react towards self antigens. Both the types of immunity, cell mediated as well as antibody mediated immunities, they never develop against self antigens. On the other hand, immune system becomes highly active against non-self antigens. What are the examples of non-self antigens? For example, I have been given a graft of skin from my relative or from my friend. Then this skin graft will be recognized by my body as non-self antigens. Okay students, my kidneys, my lungs, they are self. If I accept donation from any of my friend, then these organs from my friend donated to me will be recognized as non-self antigens by my immune system. And this is the basics of transplant rejection in our body. Okay, students? Now we continue our discussion on the topic of tolerance. Students, how we can define tolerance? Tolerance is defined as specific immunologic unresponsiveness towards antigen. Provided immune system is normal. Okay, students, I repeat the definition of tolerance. Tolerance is defined as specific immunologic unresponsiveness towards the antigen, provided the immune system is functionally normal. Students, there are three main components of this definition. Number one, specific. It means that tolerance develops towards only specific type of antigen, not towards all the antigens. Okay? Second component of definition is immunologic. Immunologic means immune system of our body. And third component is unresponsiveness. Unresponsiveness means lack of response of the immune system towards the antigen. Okay? We can define tolerance as specific immunologic unresponsiveness towards the antigen, provided immune system is functionally normal. Okay, students? Now, we proceed further on the topic of tolerance. Students, there are two main types of tolerance: T cell tolerance and B cell tolerance. T cell tolerance, number two, B cell tolerance. Students, T cell tolerance mainly involves T lymphocytes, and as a result, it is more concerned with cell mediated immunity tolerance. Okay? Now, as the name indicates, B cell tolerance involves mainly the B cells, B lymphocytes. And it is mainly concerned with antibody mediated immunity, because you all know that B lymphocytes, they transform into plasma cells, and plasma cells produce immunoglobulins and antibodies in our body. Okay? Tolerance is of two types: T cell tolerance and B cell tolerance. T lymphocyte tolerance, B lymphocyte tolerance. Now, each of these tolerance type is again divided into two further subtypes. Number one, central tolerance. And number two, peripheral tolerance. Okay, students, T cell tolerance is again divided into two subtypes, central tolerance and peripheral tolerance. Similarly, B cell tolerance again divided into central and peripheral. Okay, now we discuss each of these types of tolerance with their mechanisms. Students, T cell tolerance, the ability of T lymphocytes to distinguish between self and non-self antigens is called T cell tolerance. And when this T cell tolerance develops in the thymus gland, it is called central tolerance. Central T cell tolerance, the ability of T lymphocytes to distinguish between self and non-self antigens develops during development or maturation in thymus gland, it is called central T cell tolerance. And if this T cell tolerance, T lymphocyte tolerance, it develops in the peripheral lymphoid organs, peripheral lymphoid organs, it is called peripheral T lymphocyte tolerance. What are peripheral lymphoid organs? Tonsils, lymph nodes. These are, students, peripheral lymphoid organs. So, in central T lymphocyte tolerance, the ability of T lymphocytes to distinguish between self and non-self antigens, if it develops in the thymus, it is called central tolerance. And if this ability of T lymphocytes, it develops in the peripheral lymphoid organs, it is called peripheral T lymphocyte tolerance. Okay, students, now we move towards mechanism. Students, regarding T cell tolerance, there are two mechanisms involved. Number one, clonal deletion, or we can say negative selection. Clonal deletion or negative selection. Students, what does it mean, clonal deletion? Students, clonal deletion means their T lymphocytes. Which can react with MHC proteins present at the time of fetal life, they are killed by the process of apoptosis. And this process is called clonal deletion or negative selection. Gee, students, I repeat clonal deletion or negative selection for your convenience. Clonal deletion means T lymphocytes, which are reactive against the MHC proteins, which were present during embryonic life. These T lymphocytes are killed by the process of apoptosis. This is called clonal deletion. Students, second mechanism is energy. Clonal energy. Students, clonal energy means T lymphocytes, they are either killed or they are being made inactivated to produce tolerance. This mechanism, clonal energy, it is more prevalent in peripheral tolerance, whereas clonal deletion, it is more prevalent in central tolerance. Okay, students? Now, B cell tolerance, B lymphocyte tolerance. Students, as the name indicates, B cell tolerance involves B lymphocytes, that is the ability of B lymphocytes to distinguish between self and non-self antigens is called B cell tolerance. The mechanisms of B cell tolerance are same. That is, clonal deletion and number two, energy. The difference is both of these mechanisms involve B lymphocytes. Okay, students? Now we discuss what are the factors which affect the development of tolerance mechanism. Factors affecting tolerance. What are the factors on which the development or the strength of the magnitude of tolerance develops? These factors are number one, status of the immune system. Number two, structure of antigen. Structure of antigen. students, antigens having simpler structure, they produce tolerance actively, more readily. On the other hand, the antigens which are complex in structures, they produce tolerance very slowly. Number third factor, dose of antigens. Dose of antigens. Students, sometimes very low doses of antigen readily produces tolerance. Sometimes very high doses of antigens, they readily produce tolerance. Sometimes very low doses of antigens do not produce tolerance. So students, it was all about tolerance and its mechanism. I hope that my lecture will help in clearing your concepts regarding tolerance. Thank you very much, students. Allah Hafiz.